The ITSM Success Dashboard helps you see how well your ITSM application is helping solve users' IT issues and gauge your cost savings from using ITSM. This dashboard provides two types of KPIs. Performance overview KPIs show the value of your ITSM implementation, and service quality KPIs show how well it's helping your employees. When we navigate to Success Dashboard, it opens in the Performance Overview tab. These KPIs show how well your service organization and ITSM implementation are helping users resolve their issues. For example, the self-solved KPI shows users' success in resolving their own IT issues and fulfilling their own needs without engaging an agent. You can see your percentage over time, your target, and the benchmark set by other companies using ITSM. You can define targets for each KPI, including the target value and the start and review dates. You can also see the performance for specific time periods. Here's how we did in the month of June. When we view the details for self-solved, we see breakdowns for resolutions using virtual agent, knowledge, and automated resolution, including current counts and trends over time. We can drill down for more details, like the number of issues resolved by issue auto-resolution each month. We can see similar information for other important KPIs. Call deflection tracks employee issues and requests that were handled automatically rather than by an agent. Structured tickets completed tracks requests with predefined fulfillment tasks that are closed or complete. And productivity moments are times when your agents or employees are helped by ServiceNow capabilities like NLU, predictive intelligence, or Now Assist. Success Dashboard can also give us insights into our KPIs. Here, the insight highlights a drop in performance against the industry benchmark. Success Dashboard can also help you gauge your cost savings from each service channel. Here are the cost savings from our performance KPIs. When we click the savings icon, we see our total savings and the basis for calculating these amounts. We can drill down for more details here too. Here are our total savings from self-solve, the breakdown for knowledge, virtual agent, and automated resolutions, and the trend over time. The KPIs for service quality tell us how well our service organization is helping our employees. Customer satisfaction is based on surveys following the resolution of issues. Mean time to resolve is the average time between opening and closing tickets. Percentage of breached SLAs tracks issues that breached an SLA before being closed. Percentage of first assignment resolution tracks tickets that were resolved without being reassigned. And percentage of reopened tickets tracks tickets that were reopened after being closed. These KPIs cut across all your product capabilities. For example, CSAT combines the scores for HR, ITSM, virtual agent, and walk-up. We can see insights for service quality KPIs as well. For example, we see a drop in CSAT, correlating with a rise in mean time to resolve. We see that on average, it took our agents one whole day to start working on tickets. Also, there were several incidents that were reassigned two or more times and took an average of 3 months to resolve. These insights give us two ways to reduce our time to resolve and improve our customer satisfaction. With detailed KPIs for performance and service quality, cost savings estimates, and insights to help resolve issues, ITSM Success Dashboard can help you make your service operation more effective and efficient.
To get more help, select the Help Center icon to review the available resources.
For more information, see our product documentation or knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.